The other aspect of lung function tests that you need to think about are the flow volume loops and the lung volumes. So the lung volumes are are increased in COPD. The patient has bigger overall lung volumes than normal. That may seem surprising, but that relates to the air trapping that we discussed, that I mentioned earlier, and I'll discuss in more detail in a second. The reason for the increase in lung volume is that the residual volume, the amount of air left in the lung at the end of expiration, increases. And so although the lung volumes are larger, it's useless volume. It's not air that's shifting during inspiration and expiration. It's just the residual volume that's driving the increase in lung volume. If the patient has emphysema, then they've lost a lot of surface area for gas exchange because of the alveolar destruction. And that means the transfer factor, which measures the ability of oxygen to get in from the lungs into the blood, goes down. So a low transfer factor suggests emphysema. In addition, the alveolar structures are required for splitting open the airways as you breathe out. So on expiration, there tends to be there's a positive pressure in the thoracic cavity, and that squeezes air out of the lungs, but it also squeezes the bronchi, taking the air out of the lungs. And if the bronchi have lost their structural support, then there'll be a tendency for them to be closed off by that pressure, the expiratory pressure. And that's called dynamic airways collapse, and occurs in emphysema, where the loss and destruction of the alveoli mean the bronchi are not splintered open during that and cannot combat the positive pressure of expiration. And you can see that on a flow volume loop, which is illustrated here on the right-hand side of the slide. You can see that the person with emphysema, the solid blue line, what happens as they breathe out is there's a rapid increase in flow initially, and then there's a sudden decrease in flow due to this dynamic airways collapse. And that's followed by a prolonged phase of low flow expiration. The other investigations you need to do with somebody with COPD, well, clearly a chest x-ray is useful, but actually it's not that abnormal in most patients. In patients with significant disease, it will show a degree of hyperinflation with reduced lung markings, more visible anterior rib ends than normal, perhaps flattened diaphragms and a small heart. You can see bulli on a chest x-ray. So some people who have quite expanded lung cysts due to COPD, that's a bullous, that's visible on a chest x-ray. And also a chest x-ray is important to identify complications, pneumonia, pneumothorax, and chronically to make sure they don't have cancer. The CT scan is used to identify patients who have emphysema, to look for bulli, and perhaps to look for coexistent bronchiectasis or other complications. So these are some examples of x-rays you might see. The x-ray on the left-hand side of the slide is somebody with a hyperexpanded lungs due to COPD, and basically you see black lungs, very long, thin lungs, and the heart is stretched as well. And that's a hyperexpanded pair of lungs with oligemic lung fields. The middle CT scan shows central lobular emphysema, and what you can see are black holes where there's been lung destruction, with the gray material around the outside being the normal lung. It's a sort of Swiss cheese lung. It's got holes in it. The last scan is somebody who's also has some emphysema, but that's distributed in a different way. Instead of being central lobular in the middle of the lung lobules, it's actually around the septum, around the edges of the lung lobules, around the edges of the lung. What other investigations are useful in COPD? Well, actually not much. Lung function, chest x-ray, some patients need a CT scan. Blood tests, you may want to measure the alpha-1 antitrypsin level to see whether they have early onset emphysema if they're relatively young patients, especially if they have basal emphysema on their CT scan. Normal blood tests for blood count, eosinophils, liver function tests are all normal. Some patients, you need to do an echocardiogram and ECG, and there's two reasons for that. One, the main differential diagnosis for somebody with COPD would be cardiac breathlessness, congestive cardiac failure. So you may need, or a valvular problem such as aortic stenosis. And you may need to exclude that as a cause of their breathlessness. And the other reason why you need to do echocardiograms and ECGs is those patients with chronic hypoxia may develop cor pulmonale, and you need an echocardiogram to measure the pulmonary hypertension that could be present in those circumstances. Invasive tests such as bronchoscopy or lung biopsy are not needed for patients with COPD. They're not needed for the diagnosis at all. So how do you recognize the patients with COPD? It's a combination of gradually worsening breathlessness on exertion over years or months with a significant pack year history, 25 to 30 pack year history. Therefore, most patients would be aged over 50 or so, plus obstructive spirometry. The chest x-ray often looks normal. The main differential diagnosis is congestive cardiac failure, chronic PEs, that would be a shorter history, and they'll have an abnormal transfer factor, and importantly, the lung volumes and spirometry will be normal. Chronic asthma, there's no history of smoking, there's definitely a past history of asthma in most of those patients. And pulmonary fibrosis, and this is where crackles are important, because if you hear crackles, that's not due to COPD. And in addition, the lung function pattern you get with pulmonary fibrosis is different. It's a restrictive lung function with an increased FEV1 to FVC ratio and usually a fall in transfer factor as well.